You can find me pretty much on anything, @_222, which you see right there. So yeah, I'm the leader of the
Yeah.
Yeah, hi, my name's Garwye, and I sometimes go by the name Choppy Way because people have trouble pronouncing my name sometimes. I usually just work at main cafes. I work with these two at anime usually, and my favorite anime is Cardcaptor Sakura. And I have ribbons to hand out for Cardcaptor Sakura if you participate. Just saying.
So who are we? We are AJ Connections, part of AJ Connections. There's a lot. And then we have Kaifu, which is California Idols Fans United. We kind of run that, and it's like an idol fan group for everyone in California. So if you're from California, check that out. We post not just our stuff. We post like stuff from just around the knowledge base of
a lot of different kind of idol posts. So if you're interested in not just 2D idols, but if you're interested in regular idols, underground idols, mainstream idols, we all have that there.
And then we also have the Hello Idol blog, which is our on AJ Connections. We have multiple blogs, and that's just the idol blog, so it's the idol section basically. And you can also find us on Facebook at AJ.
For some reason, I don't have it there, but we also have a bi-weekly podcast. Music. And we talk a lot about idols on that podcast. So if you like idols, we have a bi-weekly podcast. It's more or less every other Thursday. The schedule is on our Facebook page, check it out.
It's very opinion-based, the podcast. So
it's
you're easily
though.
Offended by music opinions.
Exactly.
Some people get very upset when we're like, oh, I wasn't like the best. It wasn't the best song I've ever heard. People are like, oh my god, you suck. And I'm like, okay.
Oh, sorry. Opinions.
It's really fun though, it's usually we don't have some of the members here, but you get to kind of just go over and
come in. I love you.
Come in.
Come in.
Yay!
Cool. We have
company
chairs. Anyways.
So let's get started on the actual panel. So what is an idol? I think most
anyone here?
Does anyone here not know what an idol is?
Like a Japanese idol, I just...
Okay, well, whatever, we're going over it anyways. Well, this will be quick. We'll go over quickly. Of course you put a picture of her.
That's his favorite.
Of course
I would. So it's basically media personalities within the popular music industry. They're usually role models, a figure that one can cheer on in the face of adverse conditions, and it doesn't necessarily have to be the most talented or skilled. A lot of idols are very talented, but there's a lot that aren't. It's not necessarily, like, there's something about them that makes you want to watch them, but it's not always the fact that they're good at what they're doing.
Idols here are very different because idols here mostly, they have a really good voice and everything else is kind of comes along with it. But in Japan, voice is not always the main focus.
Mm-hmm. And personality types can vary, which is something that is very, kind of accentuated, I guess, in idol animes.
Moe
factors. Yeah. So then, anime idols. They basically reflected the popularity of idols in the mainstream. So as idols become more popular, anime idols become more popular, and vice versa. Although I feel as though anime idols didn't have quite as much of a slump as regular idols did because the 90s.
Because anime is like always popular. That's
yeah.
Why.
There's always new genres coming out. There's always something fresh, and so people are always.
Yeah, there's a lot of idol animes.
Yeah.
Like, there's too many. It's kind of like scarring a little bit. The genres varied greatly. They follow a lot of the same anime themes that were popular at the time. Like, there's the mecha idol animes, and then there's like the
regular idol animes, and then there's like more extreme ones where it's really serious. Or I don't know if you included, but there's even like
there's a lot of sci-fi idol animes. That is something that I found. A lot of them are sci-fi based. And especially like recently, and I think a lot of that has to do with kind of how popular sci-fi has been getting and like lately. I mean, it's always been popular. Yeah. The characters are often voiced by actual idols, or the voice actors will like become idols. It kind of happens both ways.
It kind of made fun of me for picking the idol you saw earlier. She is my favorite. But another reason why I picked her is
she's the voice of this character.
Yes, she's the voice of this character, and it was a nice segue. Okay.
Okay, if it makes sense. That's Ki.E, we'll be talking about that later. And Yeah, so I feel like most often the actual voice will be done by a voice actress, and then the singing will be done by an idol, but sometimes the voice is also done by an idol.
Yeah, kind of like Aikatsu.
Yeah, Aikatsu is just the singing voices. We'll be talking about that later. For blurring the lines of 2D versus 3D, that's kind of where it's like, in their concerts, they'll dress up like the characters. Sometimes they'll even wear wigs.
Love Live is a very, very good example of the blurred lines. Like, are they 3D idols or 2D idols?
2.5D idols.
Yes. It's like multimedia. A lot of the big franchises are big because they become like multimedia with the games and
everything.
Like
anything.
Like, if you want it, they probably have it of it. Like, there's probably a Love Live toilet paper somewhere. I'm sure it exists.
Like,
not someone should capitalize on that. Anyway, so just some earlier idol animes of the 70s, 80s, and 90s. There's just a few. There's a lot more than this. If you have any more questions, like, we have another panel that I believe is already posted on our page that has a list of like almost every single idol anime. So if you're really curious,
yeah,
you can look at that.
To include it just because we want to see if anyone can think of anything else. And then we'll be like, maybe we'll give you something if you can think of it. But I guess we did miss a couple, so now we're like, okay.
I tried to parse.
Yeah, I should try to parse. Yeah, so many on there. But
anyway, so we have Sasanai no Taiyo, which is arguably the first anime that was ever about the music industry, which is what kind of makes that cool. It's about two girls that were like switched at birth. It's about the music industry as well. So it's a 26 episode series. It's from 1971, so like expect 1971 style
animation.
but it just like it kind of is arguably like what started off, even though they're not necessarily per se idols. Like, exactly, they're definitely, you know, it's the first time the music industry was even really discussed. And then we have Pink Lady Monogatari Eiko no Tenshi Tachi. It's about the real-life group Pink Lady, which was, like, a hugely popular group. I believe, were they, like, the first idol duo?
They were amongst the first, but they were...
They're the most scandalous happening.
Definitely. I was trying to find a mention to put that.
It's not scandalous if you think about it now, but their dance moves are like, oh no, look at them opening up their legs now. Like, they're just doing like squatting slightly, and then Japanese people are like, wow, so sexy, so scandalous. So they're really popular because it's different.
And it's one of the first shows to be based or inspired by real artists. Which is something that hasn't happened as much recently, but it was definitely a theme in the 80s and 90s, was like shows being inspired by real artists.
Well, there's one more point. I don't know why I just
And then there's Takamoto.
Oh, I think these are out of order.
Oh no.
Well, whatever.
real fast. Takamoto is a very famous idol and voice actress, who was the voice actress for the voice of Creamy Mommy. And there's just a brief thing about her. Basically, there's a concept that we're going to talk about briefly in this opening part, because it started from then, and it's really one of the main themes in idol anime, with the idea of media mix. Now media mix is basically where, how do I say this, you don't just sell an anime. You sell the product. Yes, you sell the idol, you sell her goods, you sell like her, not just CDs, maybe like a glow stick, a towel, what have you, and sell all this as a package, basically. The idea is that one side bolsters the other in any, you know, marketing strategy. It's a cool thing. Anyways, Takuya Ono was one of the first ones who brought this, you know, idea to popularity. And I think the next slide will be on Creamy Mommy.
Let me just add something really fast. It's just the first time that they would, you know, kind of promote like an unknown idol.
Yeah.
So then to use that to kind of like push like their fame, like, you know, as in I'm doing like you know, like Love Live, it was like not really approved before, and because like Love Live, they like pushed like the news.
They also.
Oh, sorry.
Just another example of this is there was if anyone knows of Lemon Angel.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
The original series, not Lemon Angel Project. There was an original series. It's almost hentai, so I didn't include it, but it was like, oh, the original one back in the 80s was specifically just to promote that group. So like, they would use anime to actually promote idols. So it's been like, it's kind of weird because I feel like there's a little bit of like a turf war between like the otaku and the like the idol otas, and like, yet still there's always been that like connection. and a lot of anime.
Like, you mean like 2D versus 3D?
Yeah. And like,
a lot of people though, they support, like, I would say.
I think nowadays it's more common. Yeah, back then it used to be like, well, I like film.
I have to choose 2D, I have to choose my 2D waifu, or I have to choose this green girl.
The Korean manga is really, really cool. One of the very first ones in IDOLM, it's kind of as we know it. It's a very ridiculous story. She sees an alien, and the alien gives her, is it a wand? Yeah, it's a wand. Because the reason I'm confused, I'll explain in a second. The game gives her a wand, and it transforms her into an older girl. Now, this older girl suddenly is discovered that she can also sing, and she gets scouted, and she becomes an idol. And various things happen. And, yeah.
I feel like it's a common theme in most of the 80s. Idol anime that like they're given something,
yeah,
and that changes them into an idol. Like it's like that's all of them.
Because it ties into the whole magical girl thing, you know, your Sailor Moons or whatever, what have you.
Yeah.
And
basically. The full moon's a little bit different because it's not an actual object. I'm thinking more of like
the one
where the singing's bad.
Oh my god.
What?
But anyway, we had. Unfortunately, the slides are a little out of order, so we just breeze through this one. Just the concept of the media mix. Garwye did bring up a good point that I actually kind of forgot, is that another main concept of this is they're kind of both unknowns. The show is usually new, and the idol is usually new in terms of that she hasn't released anything else, like, you know, publicly, officially, elsewhere. So the idea is you get two new properties, they grow together, and you have all sorts of other media in terms of...
Concerts.
Yeah, exactly. Media in terms of like other products and whatnot to sell, and that's pretty much all you know there. By the way, that's Mari Iijima from Macross, as you can see. Yes.
Just a few other notable '90s idol anime. So first we have Idol Tenchi Yokoso Yoko. That's the first picture, the one farthest on the left. That is about a girl and her flying squirrel who go to Tokyo and hope of becoming an idol, and then she meets people, and then they like.
I don't know why Japanese people love putting random weird creatures into like almost kids' animes or.
No, it's funny.
The sidekick.
No, it's funny you say that. Actually, I read something on it very recently. I didn't know if that was an issue that we discussed before, but I read something on it very recently in terms of that. Because Disney's popular and Disney has talking animals. Anyone remember when Pocahontas came out and it was like, the animals don't talk? This isn't Disney. So yeah, the animals talk.
Magical animes have it.
It's a leftover Disney trait. Just like the eyes, they always say.
So the animals don't talk, but the tree talks.
That's true.
Grandmother Willow.
So then we have Key the Metal Idol. Key the Metal Idol is basically about a girl who is a robot, even though she looks like a human, and then her grandpa. Someone tells her that she has to make like 12,000 friends or something like that. It says it here, so let me just read this. Her grandpa tells her that if she can become a real girl if she makes 30,000 friends. So she's like, oh, I'll become an idol, and then I'll make 30,000 friends by being an idol.
It's a really good show. It isn't just focused on her idol thing, but the first few episodes do. It's a really amazing show. I suggest you watch it in general. It's good.
Gives you the feels.
Then we have Idol Project, which is basically, it's like a parody on all the other idol animes. Even though it was like in the 90s, they were already parodying it. It's basically about, she's a 14-year-old girl. She's come to the annual Star Festival to become an idol. It's the most celebrated event on a united Earth. So her favorite idol is Yuri, and Yuri became the president of the Earth because she like saved the Earth. It's basically a spoof on Macross, or it's parodying Macross.
I don't think you need to read the synopsis of Fancy Lala. Fancy Lala is just a ripoff of Creamy Mommy.
That's what I was thinking of, where she can draw me.
Yeah, it's a ripoff of Creamy Mommy. It was the 90s version of Creamy Mommy.
And they also lost funding halfway through, so it just like ends.
Yeah. I mean, I've never really heard anyone say that, but I think that's really what it was. Anyway.
So then we have Macross.
Yes. Anyone not know Macross? Anyone not seen any Macross? Anyone a fan of the original Macross? Oh, we have a few, okay.
For those who don't know, it's a mecha anime. It's like similar to Gundam.
But idols.
the cool thing about it was, is that, okay, because there's some people, like, I remember even Molly argues with this sometimes, like, it's not necessarily about idols. And I'm like, the entire show, I mean, let me rephrase it, the entire first show, and later shows too, but the entire first show is about an intergalactic war between a new alien species and galactic peace is brought about because of an idol. An idol ends the war.
It's like, what's, they didn't need all the mecha and all the fighting, they're like, just kidding, all we need is the girl.
If you ever seen Macross Delta, the most recent one, the reason, that's not the first anime that features idols like being used as like a battle tactic in the Macross series. Macross 2, the one they retconned out, is also, they develop a Minmay attack, which Minmay is the singer from the first Macross, where that's the way they think to defeat aliens, to bring idols, and apparently it keeps working. Yeah, and the idea is, even now, it still works, and you know.
It appeals a lot to Japanese men, because they're like, not only do I get my cool robot, I get a lovely, sexy lady singing, or something like that. It's like their way of appealing to both sides. I remember my mom talking about how it wasn't a real mecha anime, because she's like, what's the point of these robots? I want real robot action. All I'm getting is this girl singing and defeating them all with just that singing.
Yeah. No, so yeah, Macross had Lin Minmay, Macross 2 and Ishtar was gonna. But anyway, Macross Plus has Sharon Apple, who was the first virtual idol, kind of like Hatsune Miku, and Macross 7 and Violent Genius, the older ones. So moving on.
We have Macross
Frontier. Now, I remember when, everyone remembers those Macross Frontier when they think of Macross.
Ending is so messed up.
Yeah. A lot of shows are messed up, but it's the third TV Macross show. Now, a lot of people probably don't remember too much is that it really like revitalized the Macross franchise. Like up until this point, it was kind of a dead franchise. Even when it did Seven was the gigantic hit that they were like thinking it would be in terms of like actual production. A lot of that's due to weird legal reasons because no one really knows who owns the rights to it in Japan, and there's all sorts of nonsense with it in the U.S. too. Why you don't see these in the U.S. officially? So it's all sorts of nonsense. But anyway. Character Plus? Anyone? I know it, but I assume everyone's seen Macross Plus.
Okay, so has anyone watched it first? I want to make sure like people haven't watched it just to make sure.
There's a time limit on spoilers.
There's a general summary.
Basically, they're looking for a new place to call like their whole planet. And then we have the main idol. Cheryl is basically our like main singer actress, and Rocka is like an upcoming actress. And then there's this one guy named Alto that is not in the picture.
He's not.
No, he was a normal boy, and then he accidentally got dragged in. I won't say how, because I feel like that might be ruining it. But he got dragged into like a war, and he started like you know fighting in the robots. And then they found out singing usually helped defeat the monsters.
Exactly.
And it was so messed up. You have to watch it. Like you hate it, and then you love it. But I can't spoil it.
Now. I'm glad she brought up all the key points I was going to bring up, because moving on to the next one, a lot of people didn't like Delta, I remember in the fandom, and I personally didn't like Delta when I first saw it. Now people were like, why didn't you like it? Because, believe me, I love it now, but it's because I've seen this plot already. I've seen the main idol, I've seen the rising idol, I've seen the accidental pilot, ace pilot. I've seen this plot, not just in Macross Frontier, mind you, but they literally rehashed on paper. If you took the bare basics of the plot for Macross Frontier, the beginning, and you just change the names and change a few details, you have Macross Delta. That was my problem with it. And also, that whole first episode just threw like 20 characters at you. And it just threw so many characters at you.
I don't understand how you do that. Like, if they're all the characters at you at once, and they're like, hey, look at these girls, they're so cute.
No, I'm not joking with you. I'm not joking with you. I did not know there were two fighter pilot squads until I rewatched it recently. I thought that was all one squad. I'm like, why are they killing each other? And I had no idea that one was the enemy. Because, like, it happened so fast, and I was like, what? If you watch it, you'll see what I mean. But anyway, the cool thing about them is they use it's an idol group, and
obviously it's more modern because nowadays more than soloists, a lot of idol groups are popular. Love Live, of course, Idol Masters. If you're thinking of like regular idols, then AKB is really popular. Like big groups are popular.
So I'm pretty sure Macross is like, oh, we need a lot more girls now to appeal to the
crowd.
Yes. And that's pretty much it. I'm gonna watch a clip, but it's a cool show to watch, and I actually gave it a second chance, and I love it, so it's not a bad show.
The music is good.
It is.
Yes.
Yeah.
Do You Really Love Is the best song ever.
Largely followed a soloist and not a group, and although there are groups later on, There's the cross-media concept with, you know, merchandise, television shows, etc. And there's also exposure outside of Japan. Excuse me. And then the CGI that was used in the anime. This was the first idol anime, I believe, to use CGI.
Yeah, it became really common. We joked about it here, but it, like, it didn't take off here, but it took off in many other shows.
So we have Koharu Kusumi. She's the only 7th gen member of Mori Musume. Then there's Kire Pika, which is Kirari and Hikaru. It's Koharu Kusumi and Mai Hagiwara from Cute, which is disbanding this year.
So, I know.
Where's that?
What?
Oh, it's there, but you just can't see it because the pictures on top of each other.
And then Milky Way, which is Kirari, Noelle, and Kobeni. Those are the character names. Which is actually Koharu Kusumi, Sayaka Kitahara, and Yu Kikawa from Hello Pro Egg, which was like their training program.
Yeah. Now they're not trainees anymore.
But they were at the
time. Yeah, they have their own solo
career. They have their own solo career, yeah. And then ironically, the one who does it is Kusumi Koharu.
Oh, yay, you used my video. Okay, so this video will show you some of the great CGI that was in this show. I hope you're all really excited.
A plus. Even though they.
Arcade video game, and then it moved to Xbox 360, and then it became anime in 2011. We're not going to talk talk about like the older series that doesn't count because it was like a mecha.
Wasn't even really.
Is that Glossy?
It's a Glossy. It doesn't count.
We're not even on the channel.
So we're gonna talk about the Idol Master anime. Came out in 2011. Based off Idol Master 2. It follows the idols of 765 production. It's 27 episodes, two seasons.
Well, the movie actually gave it its own slide at the end. It was
I know, we gave it its own slide, but.
Hi, you can come
and
in.
And then. Click. Okay, I don't ask you some Girl Girls, which is the second series. Follows a whole bunch of new idols based on the mobile game by the same name. At first, it was just a regular mobile game where you put the cards, and then it became a rhythm game, kind of like Sif. You play that. And it follows Big 6-4 Productions, Cinderella Project, 26 episode, 2 core anime. And then
for those who don't know, because Manuel was like, what the heck?
I didn't know what core was!
It is like in Japan, they are.
1 core is 12 episodes.
12 or 13. Yeah, it's like, it's. It's I think there's 3 in a year?
Yeah,
there's 3 years, so basically the year is split into 3. So that's just like 13 episodes. 12 or 13 episodes. Yes. So if you see that word ever used, it is purely used in Japan. I don't know why.
Yeah, they call it.
But that's just. Yeah.
Oh, did you have a question?
Oh, sorry.
Yeah. I just. In the anime, are these all the characters they have, or do they have more characters in the games?
There's a lot of characters.
Okay. Yeah, that's what I thought.
Yeah, it's Cinderella Girls. Like in the actual games, they have like more than 150.
There's
so
many. It's very versatile. Kind of.
But like,
if you go to the Idol Master
Wiki, Cinderella Girls anime mainly follows 14 of them, but a lot of them make cameo appearances.
It's about saying about the Cinderella Girls games that it's not translated into English like Sif is, so it kind of like has that language barrier, but it's actually really fun itself.
There's a lot of characters. It covers all the
There's so many characters.
It covers
yeah,
so many types
anime.
Of MOA
and
some of them. Previous jobs before.
And then we have Puchimasu.
Puchimasu. I wouldn't recommend this if you haven't seen the original Idol Master series. It's like the Puchis, like minis of the original characters, and they're kind of just so neat. And they feature the 765 production idols and their Puchi idols. And it's 138 episodes, but it's like a. Like 5 minutes long.
Yeah,
kind of
like
Italia.
Yeah.
Italia.
Very short.
The
Idol Master
movie.
Yeah, sorry, the picture's gone.
Oh, yeah, Idol Master movie. This isn't even on the.
I know. It's an old one.
Okay, so this is the Idol Master movie. I think it's 2014. Yep. So this movie came out. It featured the 765 idols, and it also had a different franchise, so. Idol Master has like the original 765, it has Cinderella Girls, and then it has Million Live. And so this featured some of the Million Live girls along with the 765 idols, and they kind of collaborated, and there was a movie. So that's what this is. Yes.
And then,
can you go back a little bit? Is that movie at the bottom, is that the same as the movie for the original Idol Master? Or is that
It's different.
Another one?
Like on the top where it says
that
I'm 27 episodes,
2 seasons.
That's
a series. Oh, yeah. Came out with like a movie that's just like 200 minutes long or something.
Yeah.
Whoever's listening to music, if you could turn it off, it's just a little distracting.
Is
that
even here?
Is that
here?
Oh, maybe
it's
outside.
It's outside.
Yeah.
Outside.
Never mind then.
Post
life.
Ah, sorry, I went the wrong way. But then we have the Seiyu.
So Seiyu, it's kind of like this idea of cross-media again, where you take these normal, unknown girls, and they kind of become idols because people love the characters so much, and they're like, oh, wow, I really love these voices. And then they really get into the like Seiyu themselves, and the Seiyu kind of become idols. So
Seiyu just means the voice
on the side over
voice
here
actors.
Yeah, is the original 765, and then we have the Cinderella girls voice actors over here on the side.
I was gonna put all their names, but there were too many.
There's way too many.
Yeah.
All of them, so.
But here's just a quick little video of a few of the songs. We have 2 songs from the original Cinderella, or the original Idol Master, and then 2 songs from Cinderella Girls.
I'm ready. I'm ready.
doing at home, practicing, so that's really cool.
And you can just be like waiting to go sick, being like, whoa, I'm actually in the audience.
Yeah, you hold the, what is that controller? You
have
the
PlayStation
controller.
Yeah, it's like the
PlayStation. Like, that
controller.
Becomes your
Kingblade. And that's it becomes a ghost game.
Comes your lightsaber.
But anyways, moving on. Now we have Pretty Rhythm.
Ice skating idols.
This is yes. This is in chronological order. So we had Idol Master, and then basically like there was it's Takara Tomy, and then like there's two different brands, and they kind of just like keep like competing with each other. I'm like, who's gonna have the best idol arcade games? And like they go back and forth, and that's why I like think all these franchises keep coming up. But with Pretty Rhythm, it's based on an arcade game by Takara Tomy. They're ice skating dancers called Prism Stars. I don't know why they're ice skating.
And they're no,
not,
I know.
It's not like,
it was trying to find a new idea. This isn't cool, like regular ice skating. So you thought that being on ice is cool. They flip and stuff. Well, actually, it's actually really bad. But
it's literally just them dancing and they happen to have ice skates.
They
on.
Dance, they sing, they do acrobatics, and then they ice skate.
And they all play instruments at the exact same time, too.
It's very strange.
And like special power moves.
They have prism stones. Like with fashion elements, with those are all the different elements they have. Mm-hmm. There's also love interests in Pretty Rhythm, mm-hmm. which is not common in idol anime because you know.
And they also have voice performing in this one too.
Yeah.
There is, yeah, there's the prism, the king of
boy meets world? Boy meets girl or something?
Boy meets world?
Boy meets world?
Boy meets girl,
boy
meets girl is a song, it's something
yeah, really. Disney Channel show.
But then. It's 164 episodes over 4 seasons and 2 movies, one of which is about male idols. It's called The King of Prism by Pretty Rhythm. It's from 2011 to 2016.
Still running, right? I think it's still running, isn't it? I think we put 16 because that's when we wrote this.
No, Pretty Rhythm is done. It's PriPara.
Oh, PriPara. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Yeah, Pretty Rhythm.
None of that. None of that ice skating acrobatics now.
Yeah, PriPara is more normal.
More of
an icon
sort of thing.
But first was Aurora Dream. I don't know why I said Aurora that way. Which just follows idols at the aim. It's, I mean, they're basically all the same. It follows idols while they aim to become Prism Stars. Also, while like living in their personal lives, because you know, they're most often like elementary school or like preteen or teenage girls. So, you know, there's a lot of personal problems going on as well. Ida, Nizumu, and Neon are the main characters. Then there's Dear My Future, which is 3 years after the end of Aurora Dream. It follows the unit Prisney and their rivals from Korea, which is Pureti. And that's kind of, I think, cool, because this is one of the only ones where they bring in the fact that, like, you know, Korean pop is a big...
Wow, yeah, Korean means... Yeah, it's really cool, because actually this group is, it's from, like, a really legit company, too. If anyone knows the K-pop group Kara, which was really popular at the time, it was within their company. And
yeah, Pureti is a real group. It's a real group.
Yeah, they're not around anymore, unfortunately, but it was like, whoa, the girls that are working in the company for Kara is here. Whoa, you know.
Then there's Rainbow Live, which was separate from the other seasons, and it has each girl has elements to describe their personality. Excuse me. And it's like three girls and then their rivals.
And they're little penguins.
The what?
Oh, look.
Oh, yeah. And they have little penguins.
And little sidekicks.
Here it comes again. The little animals.
Little Disney animals.
So cute.
And then we have All Star Selection, which features a girl named Lala, who then becomes the main character of PriPara, which is by this, it's literally the same universe as Pretty Rhythm. And Ida, Mia, and Naru, who are the main characters from the previous seasons. Give her lessons on being an idol. So it's basically a bridge between Pretty Rhythm and PriPara. Which is spelled wrong there, I apologize.
Oops.
We always like to catch our typos.
And then we have PriPara, also known as, it's Prism Paradise, is what it stands for. It's the successor to Pretty Rhythm. That's just a description of what PriPara is. PriPara
is way more popular than Pretty Rhythm.
PriPara is still really popular. It's still going on today. It's basically like this place. It's like online, kind of where they go to like a store. They go to the Prism shop, and then they basically like go into PriPara, and then they can just like, oh, I'm just gonna have a live right now, which I wish it was that easy. And yeah, it's actually a pretty good show. I've been watching it recently. They do silume changes, which is when they basically just hold up their microphone and go silume change, and then their outfits become all like LED.
Man, I wish I had that feature.
I know.
Yeah, I also wanted to buy LED powered, like battery powered, like lights.
I know. That's
so
cool.
Yeah.
Those
lights.
That'd take a lot of effort.
There's lovely pop, cool, natural, and celeb type idols. There's also managers, which are like the little stuffed animal things.
Of course, they're managers
that like get them their gigs and stuff. And they literally are like all the managers have super long names, but then they just go by whatever animal they are. So like the bear one is just Kuma,
oh
which
my
is
God.
Bear. But his real name is like something. It's really long. And then there's 106 episodes. It might actually be different.
It actually really not did that number. It is more.
It is more.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it's still going right now, so there's probably more.
Three seasons and three movies. So PriPara is like, is big. From 2014 to who knows, it's still going up.
Still going up.
Yep.
And it's the same kind of like groups do Pretty Rhythm and PriPara. That's why we put them all together. So Prizmi is the idol group that sang most of the theme songs for Pretty Rhythm and also PriPara. The Dear My Future main characters were based on these members, and then so it's Karen, Mia, Reina, and Ayami. It's actually, someone is different now, I don't remember them unfortunately.
Yeah.
Then we have Iris, and these are actually the voice actors for PriPara, so
they don't just
do the singing voices, they do the speaking voices as well.
The media mix again.
Yeah.
But that's just what's cool about this one is, I feel like this is one of the only ones where they do the voices as well, not just the singing. And they were like idols first, as opposed to being Seiyu first and then becoming idols. I'm not gonna go over all the names. You can look on this, we'll post this later, but that's Iris. And then we'll just do a little bit of a video of Pretty Rhythm and PriPara.
Yes.
Yes, I know, I chose yourself.
Boy song. Meets girl, that's what I meant.
You didn't say
boy meets girl. I said
boy meets girl.
Boy meets girl.
Boy meets girl. Okay. Well, AKB48 is the largest girl group group in the world. They actually won a Guinness World Record for it. There's well over 100 members. The name references Akihabara. It's split into five teams. Team A, Team K, Team B. Team 4, Team 8. Team 8 is different, but we don't need to talk about that right now. There's also sister groups around the world, and also in Japan. Their thing is the IDOLM STER community. Yes, question?
Do you mean largest in terms of members?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Yes. They have, is it them or they have all, it depends how you count them. It's a very confusing way to count them.
The actual AKB group has over 150 members. Originally, like the 48 comes from the ideal number of members is 48.
We've done AKB 48. The last time, about 6 months ago, when I researched that number, it was 139. So something around there.
And almost all of
them for this last year.
Yeah, we did.
Almost all of the original members have graduated. It's sad because they've been around for 10 years. The group, not the anime. But then there's AKB0048, which is the anime on the idols. It is a very scientific, futuristic, kind of mecha-ish.
Yeah.
Like, not like giant robots, but there's mecha.
There's space, there's intergalactic, that's intergalactic. There's
like, oh, it's intergalactic.
Is it intergalactic?
Yeah, yeah, it is. Interplanetary.
There you go.
Warfare. It's basically, it's featuring AKB. It takes place in the future after the government bans all entertainment, including idols. Some of the girls of AKB0048 can hold Gorilla Live to bring their songs to the fans. Their airplane that they, or not airplane, their like spaceship that they fly in is called Flying Get, which is one of their singles, one of AKB's singles. So what's interesting about this is that each girl that is in the group just takes they like succeed one of the other members and like take their name. So for example, it's like Takahashi Minami, who's one of, she's arguably one of the most popular members in AKB. So like, it's Takahashi Minami the fifth. So she's the fifth person to take on that name. And then once someone graduates, then someone else can take on that name. And there's like this whole weird like essence that is like there that like says this is the person that is like has the soul that is most similar to this. It's really, it's odd. You just have to watch it. And they're the idols who see fans. And all the understudies in this show are actually voiced by AKB48 members. So the people that are actually like AKB48 members in the anime are just voiced by Seiyu, but the understudies are voiced by actual AKB48 members. And it's kind of interesting because Watanabe Mayu, she voices Chieri in the anime, but there's also like a Watanabe Mayu in the show that's not voiced by her, so it's just kind of weird that like her voice is just like on another character and it's not on her. It's 26 episodes over 2 seasons. This is just quick, the voices, and then
it looks like it's a typo or like an error. It says No Name, but that's actually
the name of their group is No Name.
Yeah.
And then this is just like a quick thing, so you can, it's kind of hard to see because it's not the greatest picture, but they did try to animate them so they look like the actual characters.
Hair color is always one of the biggest
things. Yeah, hair color is different.
Other than the hair color, though.
Like a little heart.
Yeah. But like, they're supposed to actually look similar to the characters that they like represent. Except for Koji Haru, like, I don't understand what they did with her.
Yeah.
Looks nothing like her, but anyway. And just another slide of some more of those. And then we'll just do a few songs from AKB48. If I start singing it, I can
AKB! Thank you. に아이돌 活動 IKATSU
始まります Just a quick, well, that's basically what the characters say at the beginning of every single episode. And if you watch, crap, is it on Thumble? No. Is it on Thumble Stars?
No.
There's a male anime that's made by the same people. It's basically a male Aikatsu.
Dream Fest?
Yeah, Dream Fest. Dream Festival, like he basically says the exact same thing. Like one of the male characters comes out and is like, and the soundtrack is really similar. Like I was watching the first episode and I was like, it's Aikatsu, but it's guys.
So if you're more into that kind of thing, maybe that would be better.
But Aikatsu, it was a collectible card game by Bandai. It's the Data Cardasso card. Cardass is a horrible name, but it's like the name of a lot of these games.
Yeah, it's a card game where you go in and you sit there, you put the card in, and then you see the character come, and you're like, whoa! And a lot of times it's not little girls that are playing, it's like big men.
The games are made for little girls.
Yeah, they're very small, but it makes a lot of money.
Yeah, one of the best things is in Japan, you see the arcade stands and the chairs are so short.
They're so small.
But you see like old guys playing it and like older women playing it.
The kids are just watching from the back. They're just kind of like, oh, okay, cool. They're not playing. They're just watching.
And they're rhythm games, just in case anyone was wondering what kind of games they are. The first two seasons follow Ichigo, Aoi, and Ran, and the last two seasons follow Akari, Sumire, and Yunaki. There's cool, cute, pop, and sexy type characters. It's pretty obvious which ones are which, although the ones you would think are cute are usually pop, and the ones that you would think are pop are usually cute. I don't know. And then the idols use cards to select outfits for their performances. To idols, cards are life. It's like a big theme in the show.
That's how they sell the cards.
Yeah, that's how they sell the cards. Like, you need life.
That's how the little girls are like, Mom, buy me all these cards.
And like, all the parts of the card, like the hat, and then the shirt, and then the skirt, and then the shoes.
You gotta get the complete set.
Top-down suits.
Yeah. It's probably a cool dream to be able to change clothes that way. And just pick,
it would be nice.
That would be nice.
That'd be the best wardrobe ever.
And it's 178 episodes. Oh, sorry. And three movies. I have watched all of them because this show is really good, guys. And I think what makes it good is, I'm not sure if everyone agrees with me, but I will state, and people might get angry about this, but this show has the best music of any idol anime. I will make that statement. I will stand by it.
It has such a wide genre.
That's the biggest thing.
It's more like modern.
There's
a lot of cool songs and a lot of like popular songs. Like, oh, people relate to it.
It's really good. The song that I sang earlier, Tinted Ballerina, is from Aikatsu.
All I can see before.
Yeah, and also, if you look up in on the very right of the picture, the second person down, that's the character I'm cosplaying. She's the mascot for the store. She's like a really minor character in the anime. But it went from 2012 to 2016. And then there's Aikatsu Stars, which is
new Aikatsu.
It's new Aikatsu. It's a different universe, but it's the same like system of the cards. It's basically based on the new Aikatsu card game, also by Bandai. And it's Bandai and Tapara told me that those are those two groups that are always like fighting over who's gonna have the next best idol anime. And it's basically Yume Nijino and Koharu Nanakura enter Yotsuboshi Academy in the hopes of joining the idol group S4, which is the four heads of the Flower Song, Bird Theater, Moon Beauty, and Wind Dance classes at their school. There's also an M4, which is like the male division of the school. And there are possible love interests in this show as well, which is not common in idol anime, as I said before. But one of the things that's cool about Aikatsu is kind of like Kirarin. It delves into a lot of things. Like there's scandals in it. There's an entire like episode, like a little mini arc about how Ichigo ate too much food and got too chubby, and they're like, you need to go on a diet. It's like an entire episode just about that.
Like that episode of Love Live.
And so it's like, it delves into kind of like
the nitty-gritty.
And it's already an episode, 28 episodes so far. I think it's more actually now. Like 30 something.
It's about 41 episodes.
Or 40 now. Sorry, we need to update some of these numbers. But it started in 2016 and it is still going. So we have the idol groups that provide the singing voices for the cast of Aikatsu. It's basically star anise, which is a type of flower.
Totally.
Not anise,
but
yes.
Yeah.
They're all stars. Yes. Okay, sorry.
They sing the songs for Aikatsu, but they're not the actual voice actors for the girls, so it's kind of like different in that way.
But they're all really good singers.
Take Ron, for example. Ron, is her singing voice is Yuna, but her speaking voice is the same as Uzuki.
This isn't exactly uncommon either. We mentioned Macross Frontier briefly earlier. Cheryl Noh was voiced and sung. Yeah, was sung by someone else and voiced by someone else. It happens all the time.
And then there's Aikatsu Stars, which is the new group. Like, I'm not exactly sure. At the end of the Aikatsu 2016 music festival, they were all crying and I couldn't really understand what they were saying, but I think that someone was leaving the group. And it wasn't for Aikatsu Stars, it was for Star Anise, so I think that Star Anise might be done. I don't know. Don't take me.
We have a question over there?
Oh, yeah, sorry.
No, I was just saying, I think Mona has graduated from Aikatsu Stars.
Oh, that's what it was. Okay, I was like,
everyone's crying and I don't know why.
Sometimes it's hard to get like this information when you don't speak Japanese. You're kind of like, I like this thing, but I don't know what's happening right here.
Which I understand Japanese to a point, but when you're crying and speaking at the same time, I'm like, what the? But Aikatsu Stars is basically the singer that provides the singing voices for the cast of Aikatsu Second Generation and also Aikatsu Stars. They're not quite as good at singing as Star Anise, but they're still really good. Like, the voices in this show are amazing.
Okay.
Okay. There's specifically one person I'm thinking of, but yeah. Oh. decides to enter Love Live! School Idol competition. And so it's 26 episodes. sorry, spoiler, they do save the school. But 26 episodes, one movie, and one OVA. It's also a multimedia project, obviously. There's CDs, there's the anime, music videos, there's the games, etc.
Time
limit.
Yeah, I
know.
Okay.
And it renewed popularity in the US with idol anime. Obviously, Love Live! Is extremely popular in the US, which is interesting because I feel like it's not actually as popular in Japan as it is here.
It is super popular. But like, I wouldn't say it's like the only one because people here only know Love Live.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
But like in Japan, there's so many idol animes that are popular, and Love Live is definitely one of them.
That's what I meant. It's just like it's not like the only one, which I feel like makes it seem so popular here because the other ones just aren't as popular. I guess Idol Master was pretty popular for a while, but unfortunately, no one.
Japan is a big fan base.
We kind of glanced at it. I think part of the reason why this one's so popular in the US is because the actual game is read easily
translated
available.
English.
It's translated in English, but there's no fuss about downloading, you know.
You don't have to go through weird.
Yeah, exactly.
They open to the US market.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, this is so cute.
And then we have Love Life Sunshine, which is basically the second series. Oh, do we have a question in the back?
No.
Or are you taking a selfie? Okay. Well, so we have Chika Takami, who is inspired by Muse, decides to start her own school idol group. Aqua to save her school. Yay. Similar plot.
Basically, almost same plot. Yay.
And they enter the same Love Live! School idol contest as Muse. It's a completely new cast. It's very similar content to Love Live!, but it's 13 episodes. So far, 2016.
You can literally take each girl and like pair her next to her the Love Live counterpart, you know. There you go.
Except for Madi in a way. Madi, I often compare as a female Joseph Joestar. Because of the English.
Oh my god!
The actual like cast of the original Love Live.
And then we have the cast of Aqua. I'm not going to go over all of these names right now, unfortunately. We're running a little bit low on time. But we'll do this. I might cut out the last song just to move on. But I'm sorry.
Love Live,
Idol
Master, just
So now we have a really quick trivia section. What we're doing is we have a lot more idol animes to talk about, so we've sectioned them off, and whoever gets the trivia question right will basically get to choose which direction we go in and which animes we actually talk about next. So you get to be part of the panel, kind of, sort of. So trivia question, we'll start with this. If anyone gets this right, they will get to choose it. So,
the arc opening the box.
Oh, okay. So, the question is going to be about Aikatsu, because everything about my life is Aikatsu right now. What is the profession of Ichigo's mother in Aikatsu? I saw your name first.
She makes bento boxes.
That is correct.
Yeah.
So, just choose a letter. Which letter would you like to choose? It is in chronological order. I will give you that hint on kind of what animes you would be choosing to talk about.
I'm just gonna choose G, since that seems cool.
Okay, we'll go with G.
Yeah.
We still have to go through all of them. I'll just show you real quick.
Can you just show the pictures and when we talk about the plots?
Choose one question. Full Moon Mosakishite. Mosu Kagaku series, One Double Style.
I know, they talk about Full Moon. The Lemon Angel Project. Oops.
Full Moon.
Lemon Angel Project. Okay, it's back. B. Lovely Idol. Skip B. Hime-chan Otogi Chiku Idol Lil B. Uta no Prince Sama. Sorry, guys.
Oh, no Otogi. No Otogi. Oh, my gosh.
Like,
well,
it's so popular.
So
I kind of like Uta no Prince Sama. It was through Toma. Toma's voice actor in Jupiter was the voice of Otoya. Yeah.
Yeah, unfortunately, we don't get to talk about that one today, but.
No Koi Ken.
And previous. Yes.
No way.
In previous future panels, who knows what we'll be talking about then? So, we have Koi Ken and Watashi Tachi anime ni nachatta. Backstage idol story, which is this is anime. Miss Monochrome and Loco Doll. C is.
What about Wake Up Girls?
It's on here. Minarai Diva, Shonen Hollywood. It's another male anime. Wake Up Girls, Venus Project Climax. There's only 4 on that one. Sorry. Sore ga Seiyuu, Million Doll, Star Mew. Oops, went the wrong way. Nurse Witch Komugi-chan R. Specifically that one, the rest of them are just cosplay. That was only 4 on that one. Okay. F, Girlish Number, B Project, Dream Festival, Buddy Go. So there's some of the boy ones. I believe G actually does have a few of the male animes on it though, so we can talk about some for you. Yes, it does. So first, we have Tsukiyuta, the animation. So Tsukiyuta is it's a bunch of characters based on the 12 months of the year, which is actually pretty cool. It's like a not often done concept. There are also girl counterparts, but not in the anime. In the anime series, the member of Six Gravity and Procellarium are all living in the same dorm building. Hajime Mutsuki and Haru Yayoi, the eldest member of Six Gravity, are first year university students. Each episode of the series will feature a different main character. So that's that. There's also a movie of Tsukiyuta coming out. Then there's Seko Boys.
Oh god.
Which is okay. So it's this girl, she becomes the manager for a group called the Seko Boys. And they're idols. And they literally are idols. They are the physically they are the statue busts of different idols. So they're also one of the Rockies. Greco-Roman sculptures, St. George, Mars, Hermes, and Medici. Their 4 busts are new to the entertainment scene, and it's up to Miki, their manager, to ensure the Rockies' prosperity in the idol world. But will they be a stone-cold success, or will Miki's management prove to be a rocky start to stardom? Whoever Miki's These descriptions were taken off of the Idol News Network. I did not write them. Then we have Idol Memories. This is a very recent one. It actually just aired. And it's a story of idol. It's set in the near future, where live idol music performances in virtual reality have become commonplace. Against the backdrop, a pair of rival idol groups compete for the coveted tiara, which represents the number one spot in the idol league. Then we have the Crane Game Girls, which is very indie, but it is on Crunchyroll. I've watched a few episodes. The series follows 3 girls aspiring to become idols while also working part-time at a game center. Little do they know that in reality they are gathered by a mysterious organization to protect the Earth from a large meteorite. It could be the one that's supposedly going to crash into America, or not America, into the Earth in February, which is scary.
C See, if this was an 18 plus kind of, we said each one's gonna be the H one, the etchy one. But Keisha, no, there's no H. I'm gonna say, but just to let you know,
well, H is just, we get to choose.
Yeah, H meant that we were gonna choose. So we kind of pulled.
But yeah, there are ATR hentai idol animes. We are not talking about them in this panel, but they do exist. If that's something you're interested in, I'm sure you can find it on your own. So then we have the current or future animes. This might not be a cohesive list.
There is a currently streaming one that I've been watching.
Yeah, we're talking about them right now.
Yeah,
we haven't mentioned them yet. So there's Idol Incidents.
That's the one.
Yeah, which is currently airing. It's basically idols as politicians. So I feel like there's the...
Yeah, that sounds better than...
And the parties, the political parties are the heroine party. Heroine as in like heroes, not men. The Sunlight Party, the Starlight Party, the Baishoujo Party, the Wakaba Party, the Subculture New Party, and the SOS Party. So from the 7 idol political parties, the idols who have become the National Diet members and representatives for each prefecture will smash through the sense of stagnation covering Japan using the power of song and dance. They're really coming up with some interesting ideas in idol anime lately. Then there's Marginal Number 4, which is another male idol anime. It follows the Marginal Number 4 unit, who made their debut in Re-Regent, fictional Pythagoras production label on February 13th. The members give their all for their fans in their idol activities, but they are also normal high school students, so the anime follows both their life as high school students and their lives as idols. Then we have Ensemble Stars! Woo!
Oh, it's getting its own.
Which is Yumenosaki Private Academy, a school located on a hill facing the ocean, specializes in boys' idol training. The game is that due to special circumstances, you're a transfer student and you're the only female in the entire school. I'm not actually sure. Did this start airing yet? Does anyone know? I don't think it has started yet. Quite yet.
I haven't heard anything about it.
But there is an anime coming out at sometime in 2017, unless they change that. And then there's Tsukipro, the animation, another one. There's Tsukiutan and Tsukipro, it's all kind of similar. And it will follow the daily lives and associated drama of the four Tsukipro's very unique groups, Solid S, Quell, Sawara, and Growth. And then we have Idolish 7, which is working at an agency owned by this is the game, because the anime's not out yet, so I don't know what the anime's gonna be like. But in the game, you're working at an agency owned by your father. There's 7 new idols awaiting. They are all part of the idol unit Idolish 7, and each of them have unique personalities. It's your task to manage them in order to achieve the same goals as the manager and idols together. You gather the 7 unified hearts and aim for the top. And then there's 22-7, which is actually produced by, partially by Yasushi Akimoto, who is the producer of AKB48, and like everything else in Japan, it seems right now. And also it's between him, Aniplex, and Sony Music Records. It's the idols who transcend dimension. I actually submitted
this. This is totally Q&A style. Like, this hasn't come out yet, right?
No,
this has not come out yet. There's gonna be an anime, there's actual idols. I submitted an audition, I did not get a call back, but whatever.
Is there any information what happened with Heidi? Heidi did one too.
Yeah, I think she would have told us if she got
back. Yeah, good point.
And the name was chosen due to that 22 divided by 7 is 3.4, so it's pi, and it's an irrational number which cannot be expressed in integer division. Apparently that's why they chose it, yeah. Anyways though, so those are what we had. It's possible that there have been some more that have been announced since I wrote this, so I apologize if I didn't put any down. But as of writing this panel, which was like last week, we did the final touches on it, these were all the ones that were announced.
And
fortunately,
we don't have time for questions.
Yeah, for questions.
But if you have any, we have another panel later on tonight.
Please come.
Yeah.
It's also around for a little bit afterwards if anyone has questions.
It's at 12:30 in the midnight at
the second floor, I believe, is 2203. C. I have to double check that. But it's in the convention center, second floor.
At
12.
So
at 12:30
a.m. It's an 18 plus.
Yeah,
18 plus.
Last slide.
And
so that's our panel. We apologize for the technical difficulties we had at the beginning, which are a little late. But thank you all for coming. We go to a lot of conventions. Yes.
What is that?
It's 18 plus. You can't.
yeah, we can't. But you'll have a lot of interesting talks.
It's really good. It's an 18 plus panel. It's really.
It's about idols.
It's my favorite one.
Death,
but check us out there. We have our information there. we have a couple upcoming cons.
Whoever wants